Okay, so here we are at Ning.com, www.ning.com. Once you're here, there's lots of social networks you can check out. Some of them are really cool, and I highly encourage you to. One that I would highly encourage you to check out is Classroom 2.0, and this is classroom20.ning.com, or simply www.classroom20.com. It's a great site where there's lots of other educators sharing how they use technology in their classrooms, in their curriculum. I highly recommend you join that and see how Ning can be used if you're not really sure. Now, back to here. I want to set up a Ning, but I don't see any place on this page to do that. First thing you need to do is you need to register. So click the sign up to get started. You type in your requisite information, you type in the secret code here that you can read that supposedly computers can't, and you put in some details, and then you're all set. Since I'm already in, I will just use my current ID. And I'll sign in, and once we're signed in, you can see now we have this area right here in the middle that allows us to create our own network. I'm creating one for a school group that we just started at our high school, Divine Child High School. We have a group of very dedicated educators who get together, we talk, we plan out future directions for the school. The principal's on board, and everybody's there because they want to be there. We meet often after faculty meetings, go figure. We're actually still interested in meetings after a faculty meeting. And everybody who's there is there because they want to be. But we really do need a way to catch those members up who have to miss meetings. So I figure a Ning site is the way to go. So now we click the Create Your Network, and we check her out. Here's where you have to make a couple of decisions. First off, I'm going to set mine to private. I don't want to set it to public until I've talked to the rest of the members of the Justice League. Then we'll decide if we want the public at large to be able to see it. I don't think we're really doing anything too secret, but I'm not the only one involved, so I'm going to work with my colleagues. Type in your tagline. Maybe a little description, I'll save that for later, a couple of keywords. And if we had an icon of some sort, which I don't at the moment, I suppose I ought to find some pithy superhero one, but, you know, everything comes. Click Next, and then we look at our features. Now, you don't have to make all your final decisions on features right now. This page can be edited much later at your leisure, and you can, if you want to pick things up and drag them, you just pick them up and drag them around. So let's see, we don't have a description right now, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and drag that off to the side because I don't have one. I can always put it back later. Let's maybe toss a forum in here in the middle. I'm sure I'm gonna want to put some videos up there because I love fun videos, and maybe some music or other podcast type things. And then you can always toss up, we'll show you what text boxes are later and what those are good for. I think that's pretty good for now. And again, I can come back and I can change this anytime I want. Now, customize the look of it. There are lots of pre-made themes. I'm going to go with a nice red and black-ish theme because our school colors are basically red and black. Now, you can change anything you see here pretty easily. If you're a Turbo nerd, you can click on the Advanced tab and you can edit the CSS. Whatever the heck that means. I really don't know what that means, even though I'm pretty nerdy. But I guess CSS came along a little later than me. So anyway, click Next. Again, you can go back and change this at any point you want to. Now, we need some profile questions. So let me pause that while I type some of those in. Okay, so once you got your profile questions, now, let me mention a couple of things about that. So, of course, we need to know what your secret identity is. That's required. Now, if we were really worried, I would also make that private, so only the administrator, that would be me, would see it. But since I'm not worried about that, it's okay. It can be public. Why are you here? I suppose that could be a very existential question. Who is cooler, Courage or Dickie? Well, we know the answer to that, but I'll give them a choice anyway. And then maybe you got a blog or something, they want a website. Your profile questions can be anything you want. Again, these can be edited at any point after the site is finished. So again, if you don't know what you want to do right now, that's okay. We'll click Next and we'll move on to the next stage. Hey, we're ready to launch the site! So At this point, we could go back and change any of those things if we wanted to, or we're ready to launch! So hopefully I didn't blow your speakers out there. Now, as the network administrator, you get a PIN number. This is really cool because not only is your site password protected, it's also protected with a PIN. So you've got two layers of security. So if somebody guesses your password, they also have to guess your PIN before they can muck with your site. This is good. So I recommend choosing a four-digit code that you will remember, or I suppose it could be anything. I don't know. I just used a four-digit code because that's what I think of when I think of a PIN. Continue. Now the site is ready to go. So you can see we need a lot of content. You can see we got Google Ads along the side. Hopefully there will never be any objectionable ones. If you're doing a K-12 sort of educational site, there's a way to get those removed, and I'll probably talk about that sometime in the future as I try to get these ones removed. Then we got our tabs along the top. As any social networking site, everybody has their own profile page where people can leave comments or whatnot. But right now, I am the only member, so how do we invite new members? You click the Invite tab. As the administrator, you can invite people if it's private. If it's public, you can allow other people to have that access, and we'll show you where that is. So you would type in your email address here, message, send invitations. I'm not going to type in my colleagues' email addresses right now. Let's see, we go to Manage, and again, here's where you could see features, all those features we just saw, privacy and content control. This is where you could decide later if you want it to be public. You could, if it's public, you can decide whether they can see everything or just the main page. Visible only to members. We can decide that I have to approve new members before they can join. I probably won't do that for now because it's a private network. I can set it so that I have to approve photos and videos before they appear on the site. Might be good if you've got students that may put stuff up that could be problematic. And you could enable music player download links so that if they put music up that can be downloadable. Anyway, lots of great stuff to play with, and part of it is just a matter of playing.